Good morning to all. Sit in Sukhasan. Hands resting on the knees in Jnana Mudra or Chin Mudra. Sit erect. Close your eyes. Start prayer. Asato ma saggamaya tamasho ma jyotirgamaya mruchyorma amritangamaya om sahanavavatu sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavaditamastu mavidvishavahai om shanti 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 harihi om tat sat Om Namah.
Let's move on to the next one, neck movement. Place your hand on your lap in Chin Mudra position. Sit erect. Close your eyes. Now, breathe out. Bring your head down, touching your chest with your chin. Breathe in, bring your head up, stretching backwards. Be aware of your neck bones. Repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, breathe out. Inhale, exhale, relax. Now we move on to the next one, neck rotation movement. Exhale, bring your head down, touching your chest with your chin. Rotate your head from right side to the halfway. Inhale, complete the rotation, bringing to the normal position. Exhale, do it anti-clockwise. Exhale, repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale.
Anti-clockwise.
Now do it anti-clockwise. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale, relax, slowly breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now we switch over to spinal movements. Spinal movements help us in many ways. This movement massages abdominal organs. It melts cholesterol in the stomach. It helps in weight loss. It also helps and increase body flexibility. The first one is boat rowing, Dandasana. Stretch your legs out and join them. Stretch your hands out forward to your shoulder level and fold your fingers. Now exhale, bring your upper body forward. Inhale, bring your upper body backward. Do it like rowing a boat. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. It should be like rowing a boat. Exhale, inhale. When you come forward, it is exhale. When you go backwards, it's inhale. Do the same in anti-clockwise. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Relax. Dandasana. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now we move on to the next movement, Chakki Chalan, Samasthiti. Bring your both legs together. Now leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Bring both your hands out and interlock both the palms. Now inhale, rotate your hands in a clockwise direction, bending your body backwards to the halfway. Exhale, rotate your hands to complete the rotation, bending your body forward. Now do it for 3 times. Inhale, exhale. Don't bend your legs and touch your toes while rotating. Remember, you should not bend your legs, and while rotating, you should touch your toes. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Now do it in anti-clockwise. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Relax. Dandasana. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Now we move on to the next one, spinal twisting movement. The next one is spinal twisting movement. Samasthiti. Join your both legs together. Now leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Stretch your hands sideways to your shoulder level. Now, exhale, turn your body to your right side, touching your right toes. Inhale, come to normal position. Exhale, turn your body to the left side, touching your left palm. Inhale, come to the normal position. Now repeat this for 3 times. Exhale, turn right side, touch your toes. Inhale, come to normal position. Exhale, turn left side, touch your palms. Inhale, come to normal position. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Relax. Dandasana. Slowly inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Samasthiti. Sit in Sukhasana. Samasthiti. Now let's start Gomukhasana. It is also called cow pose. It is called cow pose since it resembles cow face. Let's see the benefits of this Gomukhasana. It helps curing sciatica. It relieves stress from lower and upper back. And it strengthens muscles in both hands and legs. Let's see the technique of this Gomukhasana. Now, fold your right leg and bring your right feet under your left hip. Now, fold your left leg and bring it beside your right thigh. Make sure your both knees are one on the other. Now, slowly raise your left hand and bring it back to interlock it with right hand. Now relax. Now let's do the same Gomukhasana in the opposite direction. Fold your left leg and bring your left feet under your right hip. Next, fold your right leg and bring it beside your left thigh. Make sure your both knees are one on the other. Now slowly raise your right hand and bring it back to interlock it with left hand. Relax. Now, Dandasana. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Let us start Janu Sirasana. Janu means knee, Siramu means head. Since you touch your head with your knee, it's called Janu Sirasana. Now let's see some benefits of this pose. It reduces abdominal fat. It strengthens and flexes backbone. Now let's see the technique of this Janu Sirasana. First, Samasthiti. Hold your right leg to see that your palm reaches your pelvic. Raise your both hands up and slowly bend forward to hold your big toe. And touch your knee with your head. Relax. Bring your hands down. Release your leg. Slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Samasthiti. Now let's do it with the left leg. Fold your left leg to see that your palm reaches your pelvic. Now raise your hands up and slowly bend forward to hold your big toe. Touch your right knee with your head. Hold there for a few seconds. Relax. Now bring your hands down. Release your leg. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Now let's start Purvottana Asanam. Slowly raise your whole body up, balancing on your both hands and both feet.
And fully bend back.
Bend your head completely. Now relax. Dandasana. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Dandasana.
Now we switch on to Vakrasan. First, fold your right leg and bring it beside your left thigh. Raise your left hand and bring it around your right knee and touch your right feet. Stretch your right hand to your back and turn back side. Relax. Now we do this Vakrasan with the other leg. Now fold your left leg and bring it beside your right thigh. Raise your right hand and bring it around your right knee and touch left feet. Stretch your left hand to your back and turn back side. Turn back side as much as you can. Relax. Dandasana. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out.
Let us repeat all the steps one by one. Step 1, Pranamasana. Step 2, Hasta Uttasana. Step 3, Pada Hastasana. Step 4, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 5, Dandasana. Step 6, Ashtanga Namaskara. Step 7, Bhujangasana. Step 8, Parvatasana. Step 9, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 10, Padahastasana. Step 11, Hasta Uttasana. Pranamasana. Relax. Raise your hands up. Bring your hands down. Now, let us repeat all the steps one more time. Step 1, Pranamasana. Step 2, Hasta Uttasana. Step 3, Pada Hastasana. Step 4, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 5, Dandasana. Step 6, Ashtanga Namaskara. Step 7, Bhujangasana. Step 8, Parvatasana. స్టెప్ 9 అశ్వసంచలనాసనం. స్టెప్ 10 పాదహస్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 11 హస్త ఉత్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 12 ప్రణామాసనం. Now relax. Raise your hands up. Slowly bring them down. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Now let us repeat all the steps one by one. Step 1, pranamasana. Step 2, hasta uttasana. Step 3, పాదహస్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 4 అశ్వసంచలనాసనం. స్టెప్ 5 దండాసనం. స్టెప్ 6 అష్టాంగ నమస్కారం. స్టెప్ 7 భుజంగాసనం. Step 8, Parvatasana. Step 9, Ashwasanchalanasana. Step 10, Padahastasana. Step 11, Hastavuttasana. Step 12, Pranamasana. Now relax, raise your hands up, bring them down, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now Savasana. Now slowly lie down on your back. Leave some space between both the legs. Stretch your hands a little. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale. Now samasthiti. Bring your both legs together, hands together. Slowly get up and sit. Kapalabhati is also known as Kal Shining Breath, Kapala means skull and Bhati means light. The emphasis is on the exhalation through strong, fast abdominal contractions, and so has a cleansing effect on the breathing pathways. Now let us see the benefits of this Kapalabhati. It improves circulation, especially to the brain, which gives the skull shining effect, energizing the mind and waking up your system. Kapalabhati also creates heat and increases and stimulates the digestive fire, which is also called Agni, by strengthening, massaging and toning the abdominal muscles and digestive system. Let us see the Kapalabhati technique. The inhale follows naturally after the strong exhale. Relax. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now let us repeat this Kapalabhati one more time. The inhale follows naturally after the strong exhale. Relax. Slowly inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale.
Now let's start Nadi Sodhana Pranayama. Nadi means subtle energy channel. Sodhan means cleaning, purification. And pranayama means breathing technique. Nadi Sodhana or alternate nostril breathing is the most important breathing technique to help keep the mind calm, happy, and peaceful. This technique balances two of the most significant nadis or energy channels. Now let us see the benefits of this Nadi Sodhana pranayama. Nadi Sodhana also balances the two hemispheres of the brain. It is an excellent relaxation technique, calming the mind and generally bringing balance to the whole system. It improves concentration and mental focus as it clears out blocked energy channels in the body. Now let's do the technique. First, form Pranamudra. You need to observe this very closely. Now, close right nostril with right thumb and inhale with left nostril. Now, close left nostril with right ring finger and little finger and exhale through right nostril. Now let's do the same in an opposite way. Now inhale through right nostril. After that, close right nostril with right thumb and exhale through left nostril. Let us repeat this process for 5 times. Inhale,
exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now relax. Inhale. Exhale. Now relax. Now slowly inhale and exhale. With both the nostrils, slowly inhale, exhale. Let us move on to the next one, Bhramari Pranayama. It is also known as humming bee breath. Let us see the benefits of this posture. Bhramari relieves stress and cerebral tension. It also helps elevating anger, anxiety, and insomnia. Now, sit in a comfortable meditation asana. Close the eyes and relax the whole body for a short time. Put your index fingers in both of your ears and start listening to the humming sound within your body. The humming sound should be smooth, even, and continuous for the duration of the exhalation.
Relax.
Start Swasti prayer. Sarvesham Swasti Bhavatu. Om Sarvesham Shanti Bhavatu. Om Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Tas. Om Namah. Thank you.